with my interest in population, I was invited to chair the Sierra Club's Michigan State Committee on Population Matters in 1971. And I went on to become the chair of the National Sierra Club's Population Committee from roughly 1972 to 1974. And we tried to work on these issues then. Starting up FAIR required an executive director, and I had met a fellow by the name of Roger Connor, who had been one of the organizers of Earth Day 1970 at the University of Michigan, where he was studying law. And he went from law school to the West Michigan Environmental Action Council, where he spent 5 years. And I convinced Roger that population was part of the problem. And I got him on the ZPG National Board. And when we started to decide to start FAIR, I asked him if he'd like to move to Washington and become its executive director. And he agreed to do that. So with this, I suppose all shows that I'm a great believer in cronyism. I've very few times in my career have I picked people out of the blue that I didn't know anything about other than maybe recommendations. I almost always have worked with people I had some relationship with before who I knew the steadiness of their character and knew what we could rely on as an product. So I'm a great believer in that, and I still work with strongly with people I've met one way or another years back sometimes. Roger is quite an interesting character. Having finished law school at the University of Michigan, one of the premier law schools in the United States, the only case he ever filed was against Shell Oil Company, dealing with the drilling of natural gas wells in the northern lower peninsula of Michigan. And one of the fascinating things that came out of that settlement was the establishment of a state fund into which the royalties that were due to the state were put. This became a major source of conservation money ever since. And I'd say we probably have garnered some $600 million out of that fund to buy land for parks and to block in ownership in state forests and things of that nature. So it's amazing how these things, one thing leads to another if you follow leads. We've had quite a bit of study through the years of what it takes to make a good organizational name. One of the things is you need an acronym that's pronounceable, and it's best yet if it could be a word, and better yet if the word can be about one of the things that you're being concerned about. So we were concerned about fairness. Fairness to whom? Well, fairness to the people who were here, our fellow citizens, first of all. And we spent a long time juggling the different names for organization rounds to be kept to come up with this particularly fortunate one.